Shall we start our class?
Yes.
So this is my Docker machine which I have launched yesterday. So go inside this one. Sudo. So you know, right? The commands, you know, how to we have already seen how to create container, how to see list of images, and how to see list of containers. See here, Docker images. This is a command to see list of images. So we have total three images: CentOS, Ubuntu, ShoveDK. If you want to see list of all containers, Docker ps-e all. We show all containers. Okay, we have total four containers. If you want to see only running containers, Docker ps. We don't have any running containers, and you know that if you come out of any container, content will be automatically stopped. Okay, so these are the things we discussed, as well as we already seen how to create container. Now see here, if you do this one, Docker ps-a, you can see all we have all four containers. These are in stopped state. Now you know that once we create any container, by default you'll be inside container. If you come out of the container, by default that container will be stopped. Now you want to go inside already existing container. That means here, okay, test container is there. Test container, it is in a stopped state. Now we want to go inside this container. Okay, you understood what I'm saying now? Test container is there. It is in a stopped state. Now I want to go inside this container, test container. So for that, first we need to start this container because it's in stopped state, right? If it is in stopped state, how can you go inside this container? So first we need to start this container. So command is Docker start. Simple command, guys. Very, very easy commands. So Docker start and the container. Either you can use container name or container ID. Anyway, that is same. Docker start container. See here, we have started this container. Now if you want to verify whether this container is running or not, Docker ps. See here, container is running now. Correct? That's what. See here, Docker ps, it shows only running containers. Now you want to go inside this container. See here, two steps are there. You start container, then you go inside container. Okay, so we have already started. Now if you want to go inside container, command is Docker attach. Docker attach the container. Docker attach container. Docker attach to go inside container. Enter. See here, where are you now? You are inside container. Earlier you were in EC2 machine. Now you are inside container. That is how we can go inside existing container. Two steps. You need to start container and you need to go inside container. Understood? Right? Now if you come out, automatically container will be stopped. See here, Docker PS, there won't be any container. For example, if you want to start command container, see this is a command. Now you can verify Docker PS. See here it is running. Now we want to stop this container. You don't want to go inside. I mean, we are going to see why we create this container. So, you know, container is running, we need not to go inside every day. That we are going to see in our next slides, why we need to do this. Now see here, container is running. Now how to stop this container? Command is Docker stop. Docker stop container. See here we have stopped container. Now verify Docker ps. It's not like that. You can start container, you can stop container, you can go inside container. Okay, everything you can do, very, very easy. Now if you want to delete container, if you want to delete any container, okay, command is Docker rm container. See here, Docker rm, remove. First you need to stop container, then only you can delete container, guys. Remember this one. If container is in running, you cannot stop this and delete that container. First you need to stop the container, then you need to delete. So Docker rm container. See here, we have deleted this container. How to verify? Docker ps-a. You can see there is no test container here. Like that. Got it? How to delete image? See here. Docker images. Now, how you want to delete images? How can you delete images? For example, I want to delete chef, this one. Okay. Docker RMI. Docker RMI and image name. Docker RMI image name. For example, chef. Like that. Now, what is showing? It is showing another. See here. Already one container is using this image. From this image, you have created a container. The dependency is there. That's why it is showing we cannot delete. I mean, normally you cannot delete, but forcefully you can delete. Docker RMI hyphen F. Like this, we have deleted. Understood it? Docker RMI image name. Docker RMI hyphen F, forcefully you can delete. Like that. Because already you have created container, right? Okay, from this one. Okay, see here the container ID is this one. Container ID is running, it's referenced to image source. Like this, it is saying, right? You must use force. Forcefully how to delete. Got it? Like that. So now verify. We have deleted, right? Docker images. No image. Like that. Understood, guys? Very, very simple commands. Any doubt in this? These commands? Still so many commands are there that we are going to see one by one. Any doubts in these commands, guys?
No, sir.
Okay. It's easy, easiest commands. Docker is very easy to guys compared to chef. Now, so what I want to do now? So far what I did, I have taken base image from Docker Hub. From this I have created container. Now, what I want to do, I want to create a container from my own image. Okay. So for that, what you have to do first, you have to do the same thing. First you have to take base image from Docker Hub. From that you create a container. Okay, you create a container. And you, I am going to create one file, simple file. I'm going to create a file. Called my file. From this container, I'm going to create an image. So by default, that image will have whatever here, for example, Ubuntu I'm doing. This is having Ubuntu. Plus this file, my file. So from this image, I'm going to create container. You understood what I'm doing now? So I'm creating this container, for example, this container B. I'm creating container B from my own image. This is my own image. See here, X. This is Y. X image is I have taken from Docker Hub. But Y image, this is my own image. Correct? You understood, guys, what I'm doing now? Everyone?
Yes.
Okay, so let's read now. So first, let's create container from any base image. So you know, right, how to create container? Docker run hyphen id hyphen hyphen name container name. For example, file container. Sorry, Docker run hyphen it hyphen hyphen name container name any container now let's check any base image Ubuntu because already Ubuntu is there in my base machine Ubuntu double slash bin slash bash simple bin bash enter where are you now you are inside container right so let's create a file touch my file where I'm creating under main root. Okay, touch my file. Right, do ls. Your my file is right. Now, what I'm going to, so let's come out of this container. Exit. See here, what I have done so far. I have created this container. Container A, I have created some container X, and I have kept one image. I mean, one file, I have created file. Now I want to create an image out of this container. Image out of this container. So if you want to create an image out of any container, command is docker commit. Docker commit and the container. Automatically image will be created. Docker commit container. Okay. Docker commit container. So enter. The image got created. Okay, image got created. How to verify the images? Docker images. Sorry. So Docker images. Now see here, one image got created. Since we haven't given any name, that's why it is not showing any name here. Okay. So what we'll do, let's give a name to this image, whatever we have created now. Okay, so how can you give the image? Docker. While creating, you know, image itself, we can give image name, guys. Okay. So Docker, what is that image ID? See here. Is the image ID. Now, what image, what is the name that you want to give? For example, file, image. File, image. Like that, we can give a name to that image. Now verify Docker images. See here we have given a name, right? Sci image. Fine. Now, if you don't give any tag, that takes latest version. It prefers the version, guys, actually. If you don't give any version, it will show latest. That means the latest version. Well, now, how to create containers from my own image? Is my own image, right? Now let's create a container from my own image. So simple, guys. This is a command, right? In this, what do you do? Change the name of the container name first. Now change the name of image. Instead of taking base image, I'll take my own image. This image, right? Fine. Simple. Docker and hyphen IT, if I have name, container name, give a new container name. And instead of giving base image, you give your own image. That's just very, very simple. Enter. That's it. You are inside the container. Now do ls. You can see my file. That is what replication of same environment. Understood, right? Hope you understood here. If you observe carefully what I'm doing now. You install thousand softwares. You create image out of this container. This image will have all thousand software from the create container and use it. I told you, right, image is a read-only file. You cannot do anything with respect to image. When you can do something, you have to create container from that image. Then you can do anything. Now I can remove this file, right? I can remove this file, rm, space hyphen rf, my file, you can delete. Now no file. Like that. If it is an image format, you cannot do anything. But if it is a, if you create a container, then you can do anything. Because image is a read-only copy. Okay. Understood, guys? This one?
Sai, what about CentOS image here?
What about CentOS? Huh, yeah, it's a different image that we have taken from base file. The Docker hub, right? We have pulled.
Okay. It's take, by default, it will take, right?
No, by default, it's, here we have pulled, right? Yesterday class, we have pulled this image.
Okay.
Yesterday's class, we have pulled this image from Docker hub.
Not from the base image, not from the base OS.
So you attended SOS class, right?
Yeah.
So yesterday we have created container by taking CentOS image. So this image we have pulled from Docker Hub.
Okay.
In this, here we can see, you can see three images. Sai image, CentOS, Ubuntu, right? So this Sai image is my own image, which I have created from my container. The remaining two images I have pulled from Docker Hub only yesterday. Okay. Now, coming to the next one. Exit. See here. So, already we have seen two ways through which we create Docker containers, I mean images. See here. One is.
Sai, one question. Sorry to interrupt you.
Yes, please.
So when you say when we come out of the container stops.
Yeah.
Stops means whatever the processes that are running on that container, it's going to be stopped or what?
Yeah, that will be stopped.
Okay, all the processes started on that container will be stopped. Okay.
Yes, yes. Okay. I'll tell you in our subsequent classes, you'll understand how to run the container as well. Even though if you are not inside, still you can run this container. Container will be in a running stage.
Okay. Okay.
That we are going to see. Okay. So next, coming to third one, see here. There are total three ways through which we can create Docker images. The first one is pull from Docker Hub. Second one, your own image from container. Okay, first one, pull from Docker Hub, that already you have seen. Your own image from Docker container, that also we have seen just now. Okay, we have created image from our own container. And the third one is Docker file. This is very important. There are three ways through which you can create Docker images. Third one is Docker file. What is Docker file? Docker file. What is Docker file? Docker file is a normal text file. Text file, we give all instructions in Docker file. Okay, so if you execute this Docker file, image will be created with your required operating system, required software, everything. So this is what Docker file, this is what image. You understood, right? See here, I want, for example, I want to have an image of 1000 softwares. What actually you do, if you follow this for a second way, you take base image. You create container from that image. You install 1000 softwares. From that you create image. This will have 1000 softwares. It's very hard way, right? It's a very difficult process. But here, just create Docker file. You mention whatever you want. Just execute that one. That image will have OS plus all 1000 softwares. It's very easy. Okay. So I'll show that one. Shall we do it? You understood, right? You understood this one, guys? Docker file? Theoretically? Everyone? Any doubts in this one?
No,
okay, so let's do it. It's very easy. So, see here, first we need to create a file called Docker file. VI Docker file. See here. We need to create a file called Docker file. See here, the name must be Docker file only. Remember that one. That to D capital, and there is no space between Docker and file. These are default Docker file, guys. Remember this one. These are default Docker file. Okay. So if you want to create, you can create different files, but those files won't be default files. Okay. That's why better to create like this one, Docker file. Now you might be having a doubt. See, Sai, I want to create multiple Docker files. What actually happens here? You create Docker file, you give all instructions, you create image out of that one. That means there is no relation from this one. Already you got whatever you wanted. Now you do, what you do? You change instructions. And you create one more Docker image as per your requirements. That's it. Now there is no relation again. Understood, right? Like that. So you need not create so many Docker files here. In your house, you have a plate. In this plate, you take food. Okay. So you have taken, you have taken lunch today, and to have dinner, you will purchase new plate. No, right? You have finished your food. That means that's it. You clean the plate again. You can use it, right? The same thing here also. Every time you need not to create these many Docker files, you keep only one, and that's why its a default name is Docker file. D is capital. There is no space between these two. Okay, so you create Docker file, you mention all instructions, you execute, you add one image, whatever you want, you already got. Now there is no relation. Now you delete all these things, you mention whatever you want like this. You don't need to create multiple, so many Docker files. Got it? Now I'll tell you what's the user, I mean, what's the advantage of this default Docker file? See, if it is default, wherever you see that name default, that means we need not to mention the name of the Docker file. That is very important. Okay. So see here, VI Docker file. Again, I'm repeating, guys. D must be capital. There is no space between Docker and file. Okay. Enter. It's a normal file only, right? Normal file only. Just I'm giving a name like that. So here we need to give the instructions like. See here.
Sai, one question.
Yes, please.
Yeah. So suppose I created three images out of one Docker file. So can that images have a reference that these images have been created from a specific Docker file?
No relation between these two.
Okay, they don't keep any reference.
No.
With the okay.
No reference. But if you create container from this image, then this will have reference.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. But there is no relation between Docker file and that's why you can use same Docker file.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So let's give instructions from, for example, one. And I will explain guys what I'm telling you. Echo. Sorry. See here. What actually I'm doing now? Two instructions I have given in this Docker file. I'll tell you. I'll give the list where you'll get all these instructions and all. I'll show that one. The website has. I'll give the list of all instructions. And in exam, definitely they'll ask you to write this Docker file, guys. It's a mandatory question. They'll ask you to write. They won't ask you what is Docker file. They'll ask you to write. And I have written in each and every of my interview. Okay. So instructions, in this first instruction you have to give from. Instructions you have to give in a capital letters only. From Ubuntu. That means it will take that image from your base machine. If it's not there in your base machine, it will pull from Docker. Because first thing, image, I mean, OS is important. Right? After that, I'm giving instruction run. The run means if you want to run any command, you have to give instruction called run. So what I'm doing, echo, hi, sai. So I'm outputting that one to test file that will be created under main root. That means here, in this Docker file, I have mentioned OS, Ubuntu, file, I have given one file, correct? Now, if I execute this one image will be created with the same OS, Ubuntu, plus the file. Now, how to see these two things? You create container out of this one, you can verify these two. Got it? Understood, guys? What I'm doing now?
Yes.
Yeah, so let's do it. Simple. So, already I have image, I already have Docker file. So, let's create image out of this Docker file. So, how to create image? Command is Docker build. Now you have to give a name to the image, right? -t. Let's give any name. Yes. Guys, I'm getting some background noise. Can someone please one? Yeah, thank you. So see here, Docker build. -t. And give the image. You are going to create one image, right? For that you are giving the name. I'm giving the name test. And I need to give reference of this Docker file, right? So give dot. That's it. Give dot. See here what actually happens. You know that in Linux, dot represents current directory, right? Dot represents current directory. What I'm saying, Docker build -t test. That means we are giving a name to that image which is going to be created. The name is image. Now I'm giving reference. Dot. Dot means current directory. See Docker. In my current directory, I have a file called Docker file. And that's the default file. So take the Docker file and create an image. Now you might be having notes. See, if the Docker file is in some other location, instead of dot, you give the path. That is under slash, under temp. You give the path like this. Okay. So it's better to keep in the same directory so that we can use simply dot. Dot represents current directory. What we are saying? So in current directory, I have a file, Docker file. You take that one and from that you create an image.
Okay. Sai, here instead of dot, we can give path also, right? That Docker path.
Yeah, we can give the path.
Or we can give the name exactly.
We can give the name as. Okay, yes, we can give. But since it's the same, for, I mean, we need not give, right? Because it's a default name. If you take some other file name, then you have to give the name as well as path. So, for example, test file. This is a Docker file, my Docker file. It is under temp. You need to give path like this. Slash temp slash test file. Like that. Understood?
So I have different Docker file name then, and I have kept it on the root. Then how to dot
and instead of dot, you use slash. Okay. So what is the Docker file name? For example, okay. Hello. Hello file. Like that, you give the path as well as the name of that file.
Okay.
Like. So enter, see it from Ubuntu and the file, both got created. Now I have my image ready. See how to verify the images, Docker images. You can create test image, just now we have created. Now we'll create a container from this image. Okay, we'll create image, we'll create content from this image. So you know the how to create a container. So, Docker and -int let's give any new name. For example, I'll give, because the container is already there, diary container, you cannot use the same. So, what I'll do, I'll use test container. And what's the image? I think test. Right? Test. That's it. Where are you now? Inside container. Now, do this. You can see the test, right? Right? That's all. That's the same thing. It's, you know, just creating image, but in a simplest way, in a easy way. See here, you can see the test file. Whatever, you know, we have seen here. That's what. I have created Docker file. This is a Docker file. I have Ubuntu, and I have mentioned the name of that file. So once I create image, the OS is there, or that file also is. Now I have created a container, you can see this. The same thing. Understood, guys? How to create Docker file?
Can you please open that Docker file once again?
Okay. So exit. Now open Docker file. Yeah.
So here type run echo hsi. So this is going to be display on the console, not in the test file, right?
No, it is inside the file itself.
Okay.
That, because we are outputting that one inside the file. Right?
Okay.
So what we'll do, I forgot to show that one. Here, we already created container from this one. Let's start the container. Docker. Start, what is my container? Test container. Now go inside container. Docker attach. Now it's a container do ls. Your test file is right. So let's open this file. Cat test file. See, this is a content. Got it? Yeah. Now, so like this, how many instructions we can mention? We can mention any number of instructions. So let's see what are the instructions or what all those instructions and you know important instructions we are going to see. So, okay. So we have created image, right? Now that's it. I'm done with this one. I don't want this one anymore. This instruction, because already I created that image. Okay. Now.
Sai, one more question.
Yes, please.
The image you are taking from Ubuntu, right?
Yeah.
It will take from the repository, Ubuntu repository.
No. First, it will look in your base machine.
Okay, but our base machine is like CentOS, no?
No. My base machine is EC2, Amazon Linux, right? EC2 machine.
Okay.
That image is there, right? Already Ubuntu. Already yesterday we pulled that image.
Okay.
If the image is not there in your base machine, then it will pull from Docker. Got it? Yeah. So So coming to instructions. See here, I'll mention some instructions. Or you can give any name, CentOS. CentOS also is there in my base machine. I will explain it. First let me write, then I will explain.
One question.
Yes.
So in this example, we are creating a DevOps file under a temp folder.
Yeah.
So if I want to create a file which is under a directory which is not available on that image, so will this file create that folder? Or it will throw just throw error.
It will throw error because the directory is not there. What you can do is first you create a directory.
Okay. Got it.
Okay. That why I have taken temp. Temp is already by default that will be there. What I do?
Can we execute Linux commands as well through this?
Yeah, this Linux command only. Right?
Okay, so in order to create a new directory, I need to have that commands, right?
Yeah, give run again, once again, you mention that one. Okay, mkdir and that, like that. Okay. So. I'll go to temp. Okay. Fine. See here. This is very important. See, like this, we can give so many instructions. So how many instructions are given total? Six instructions are given in Docker file. First one, you need to give OS that already from Ubuntu. Okay, that OS will be there. Workdir is. See, this is a Docker file. You have mentioned all instructions. From this Docker file, you are going to create an image. From this, you are going to create container, right? So once you log into your container, by default, you'll be under main root. But if you want to be under temp, if your working directory you want, your working directory should be temp, then you give like this, working directory under slash temp. So by default, you'll be inside temp. That I'll show that. Understood. By default, you'll be under root. But if you want to be under temp, you can give like this. Not only any temp, any directory. That will be your work directory. And so by default, you'll be under temp. And run. See, this is just a command. So one file will be created where under temp folder, one file will be created called DevOps file. Inside, you can see the content. Fine. Now, environment, my name, Sai. See here, you know that environment variables already, I think we discussed in Chef. Environment variables. Okay, what do we do? First, we define variable like my name equal to Sai. So in all these places, I'll give my name. My name. If I execute this one, this will be replaced with Sai. Correct? So first you need to define variable like this. My name equal to Sai. So that's why I'm defining my variable. My name equal to Sai. later on in container, wherever you use Sai, wherever you use Sai, I mean, sorry, wherever you use my name, it will show Sai. That we are going to see that also. That is how you can define variables, environment variables. Now, coming to copy and add. See here, these commands are almost same, but with a small difference, and these differences are very, very important. And they ask you these differences. See here, copy means just you are copying something from your base machine to your container. You have a base machine called EC2, your base machine. Okay. Here you have a file called demo file. Now, while creating container, you want to copy that onto your container. The file will be copied, demo file. That will be copied where? Under temp. We are given path rate, we have given path rate. Slash temp, the file will be created, copied. So add also same thing. If you have any base, if you have any file in your base machine, you want to copy that one to container. The same thing, add also. So see here, we are giving test file dot tar.gz. Tar.gz. So if you use copy command, the file will be copied as it is. If you give copy command, copy instruction, the file will be copied as it is without changing the format. But if you give add instruction, if the file is having tar and zip, see if the file is having tar and zip, the file will be copied, and tar and zip will be removed by default automatically. Understood, guys? If they give the same file here in copy instruction, the file will be copied as it is. But if you give in an add, if you add instruction, then the tar and zip will be removed. Okay, while copying, you understood? So these two we use to copy some file from your base machine to container. They will ask you the difference between these two. Copy means it will copy the file as it is. Add means it will copy the file by removing zip and tar, both. Understood, guys? So if you create containers here, in this case, now, if I create, so anyways, I'm getting image. From this, I'm going to create container. And this is my base machine. So in this case, first of all, copy and add. To do this one, first I need to have this file, demo file, as well as test that to in a tar.zip file, right? Correct or not, guys? Reply, please respond, is correct or not? First, you need to have these files, right, in your base machine.
Definitely.
Yeah, then only those will be copied. Yeah, fine. So we are going to create these two files. That's the first. Now, after that, once you create this container, you should be able to see total three files under temp. One is DevOps file, another one is demo file, another one is test file, right? Because these two also we are outputting, you know, we are keeping inside temp. And these also we are keeping inside temp. So inside temp folder, you should be able to see total three files. DevOps file, demo file, and test file. Right? So let's do it. First, let's create an image from this one. Let's create these two files in your base machine. Demo file and test file. That unit tar.gz. Okay, so do ls. I don't have anything, right? So touch demo file. Right? Demo file. Next one is test file. Now touch test file. Now do ls. We have demo file as well as test file. Now we need to apply on top tar on top of test file. So what is the command, guys? Already we discussed in Linux commands. What is the command to apply tar? Anyone?
Tar space -cvf.
-cvf. Yes, correct. Test. Sorry. Test file dot tar. And the main file, test file. Enter. Do ls. Test file dot tar. Now we need to apply zip as well, right? So what is the command to apply zip? Anyone?
Gzip.
Gzip. This one. Test file dot. Correct. Good. So do ls. We have applied tar and zip. Now I don't want this file anymore. Because see, in Windows as well, if you apply zip, then you can delete original file. Because whenever you extract this the file from this one, you'll get a new file. So I don't need this this file anymore. Test file. So do ls. So we are ready with demo file as well as test file that in a tar and zip format. Now we are ready with Docker file as well. Now let's run this Docker file. So how to run this Docker file? Docker build hyphen -t. Let's give any name to that image because you are going to get one image, right? I'll give hello image. Any name, that's up to you. Hello image and dot. You can see all instructions are being executed one by one. Here 4 by 6 by 6 total. Okay, successfully tagged hello image, right? Now see images, Docker images. You can see hello image. Now let's create container out of this image. So how to create container? You know container command. Docker and -it, -it name. Let's change the name of container. Hello. Container. And what's the image? This is an image. Hello image. That's it. Enter. Now we are inside. See here. First instruction. So where are you now? The worker DIR, right? Got executed. So you are in under temp. Correct? Now under temp only you should be able to see total 3 files, right? Do ls. See here. Test file. DevOps file and demo file. That to tar and zip got removed. Right? And environment variable. So if you want to verify the variable echo, give dollar and give the key. My name. It should show the value. Yes, it is showing the value. That's how we can give all these instructions. Still, we have so many instructions, guys. So these are simple instructions. I'll introduce one instruction in one class. Yeah.
Can you open Docker file once?
Okay, can I open before that? You understood everyone, guys? Yes. You understood these things?
Yes, yes.
Any doubts in this one? In these instructions? No one? No doubts? Okay, fine. Exit. So, yeah, let's open this Docker file. Yeah.
Here run echo allow everyone slash temp DevOps file. DevOps file we need to create before that, or it will create
no, file as well. This command already we have seen it in AWS. I mean, there also you have seen so many areas. When you give this one, if the file is not there already, the file will be created here.
Okay.
In this command especially.
Okay. That initially, will create